listening to the Intestinal Fortitude Podcast Network.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to It's Not Horror, okay?
Even a masturbation?
All of a sudden?
No, just porn.
Oh. So you just masturbate?
Until after Lent.
Yeah.
So you're going to go 40 right days and not watch porn?
Yeah.
40 days till Lent? Holy shit.
You could go 4 hours.
Yeah, Jesus.
40 days and 40 nights.
I'm not a good Catholic, I guess.
40 minutes, dude.
Damn. Like, my brain is always thinking about sex, like, all the time.
Me too.
Even at work when I shouldn't be.
You guys ready?
Right. Yeah, I'm born ready. Let's kill some fucking Bill.
Okay. I'm disappearing.
Right. Scott. You know what Scott gives me? Scott gives me those looks. He just... If I could just still... He's the son of BTK.
I love it.
All right. Hey, everybody. Welcome to another It's Not Horror, okay? Tonight is our 50th episode. Can you believe it?
No.
50 episodes.
It's been like it's been 300.
This is it.
Well, we weren't all on all 50 episodes, but in some form or another, I was on them all. So 50 episodes.
For nudie only.
Well, that's the way of the podcast. People come, people go, but the show must go on.
We owe.
So that's my What's that?
That's my love life.
Oh, right. Mona, fuck, I hear you.
So I wanted to do somewhat of a good movie for the show. So I picked Kill Bill Volume 1, and everybody's like ready to go tonight. Android is here.
What up?
Yeah.
And Heather is here.
Fuck yeah. Taylor Swift.
And Mona is here.
Hi.
Hi. And Scott is here.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Scott.
Hi.
Well, let's get right into this fucker, all right? I'm going to say 3, 2, 1, and go. When I say go, everybody hit the play button. 3, 2, 1, and go. All right. I haven't seen this movie in a long time.
Yeah, neither have I. It's been a very long time.
Is it about a guy named Bill?
Bill Casinelli.
And does he die?
Kill Bill Casinelli? What did he
kill do? Bill Casinelli.
Is this a Weinstein film?
Dude, damn it, man. That's your next Photoshop. A Photoshop of the Kill Bill poster with Bill Casinelli on it.
Oh, right. Perfect.
When I tagged the poll results, it tagged Bill, so I left it up there.
I saw that. That was great.
That was awesome. When I typed in Bill, his name popped up, so fuck it, I'll just leave it.
Benji is a dish best served.
So everybody, I assume, has seen this.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
Really, Heather?
Right. No, I've seen it. It's been a dick.
I'm
in a feisty mood tonight.
I think I've seen every Tarantino film in theaters except for Reservoir Dogs.
Nice.
Yeah, same here.
I've never seen a single one in theater.
Interesting.
Uma Thurman's career, I feel like. It brought her back from, like, extinction.
I think so, yeah. Sure did.
Do you find me sedated? Well, Tarantino has a knack of doing that, right?
Oh, he definitely does.
Yeah, he likes his old school actors, and he doesn't care if they haven't done nothing in 20 years. He'll put them in a movie.
Yeah. And you get a great performance out of them, too.
And by the way, this is the second movie in a row that's had David Carradine in it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good job, Scott. Like
to believe. Fun facts. You're
aware enough. And probably our only repeat person, too. I don't think we've had any movies with multiple people.
I think we have.
Maybe two. I don't know.
But not like super.
I mean, we have, because Orgasmo and Basketball.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I guess. Parker,
yeah, but you guys don't talk about Basketball. Because that was
I should delete that show.
No, you shouldn't. I love it. The
only thing I wish that wasn't deleted was the damn apology, but okay.
Yeah, that was funny because you hung up. I heard the apology, and I'm like, and he's gone. Yeah. He's not even here right now.
And he's turned off the recording, too. The one time. Anyway, that's history under the water under the bridge, not history under the bridge.
It's like history too. You know, every time I put on this Cheech and Chong tank top, all I can think of Android is Mexican American. Like, and when they get up in the morning, they move real slow. Every time I hear the song.
God damn. I've been waking up real slow this past week. I'll tell you that much.
Oh yeah? Is it because someone's been keeping you in bed?
Yeah.
Nice.
My sleep.
Oh.
Brucifer.
Nah, those guys, those have their little cages. They're little, big cages.
Yeah, they're thick.
They love their beds.
I loved you, reposting that picture of your daughter trying to jump the doggy wall. That makes me laugh every time I see it.
That's what happens to me if I try to jump anything. Like, not doing it. I already know what's gonna happen.
Yeah, by the way, Android.
Yes.
You're such an ass.
Why? Oh.
He knows. Parents,
yeah. Hey. Don't speak to my husband that way, Scott.
Yeah.
He's trying to steal Scott's girl.
One of my wives.
Just so we're clear, Andy was second. I was.
MR fighting words.
I was like, Heather's gonna fight to the death for that one.
Yeah, Android was my man.
Well, I was trying to post something from my phone really fast, and then I posted the wrong picture.
Uh-huh.
You were such a liar.
No.
Right. Yeah, we look like we were born yesterday.
No, the first picture I accidentally had posted, what's her name? Alyssa from Android Vision Group. And I was like, fuck. Yeah. And then I saw that. And then I was like, because I was pulling them from a certain file that I have on my phone, and... And I was like, oh, fuck it. I'm just going to put this one up with fucking Scott. Oh, fuck it. I'm going to put this up with Heather. And I just kept going. And then I finally put the real one up.
It's like you forgot who your wife was.
You were just putting up all the hot chicks you knew.
Yeah.
Here I was feeling flattered.
No.
I'm no.
No. No. No.
Don't. Wow. I'm fighting a sneeze back. Sorry.
Mic drop.
That's okay.
No, that wasn't it. That was me. No, that wasn't it. I'm trying to fight a sneeze. That wasn't it. I put the wrong up, and then I started putting the other ones up, which is really fun. And I knew that I was trying to bait what's his name into it, anyways, because he's like, that's Heather.
Phil.
I know. Well, Phil knows who I am. He stalks my Facebook page.
Does he?
No. Well, sometimes.
But she has on her Taylor Swift outfit.
He's like, do you like Taylor Swift too?
Oh, shit.
Just kidding, Phil.
I love this music.
Me too.
It's the best.
Okay, so what movie did Quentin Turner rip this one off from?
The music?
Yeah.
A Shaw Brothers movie.
One of them, huh?
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't know which ones, but one of the million of them.
So, ladies, she just got kicked in the pussy. Is that hurt? You've been kicked
in the
pussy?
Yes. A cunt punch? Yes.
Especially if the foot goes up there. No lube.
Bruises those lips.
Jeez, it just sucked the foot in. Gosh.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think your pussy's that big.
No.
Like a vacuum. Well, if you kick in there, it might go. You don't know.
Dude, he saw that porn. He's like, I saw it in a porn once.
Yeah, last night. I had to search foot fuck, and there it was.
Toe fuck.
Foot fisting.
So fucking.
Some good choreography.
Right? Absolutely. Hails to Zoe Bell as Uma Thurman's stunt double.
Yeah, she's Zoe good.
Bell's incredible. Zoe Bell. Like, it blew my mind when I watched Death Proof, just seeing her do all that shit on that car.
Mm. All right.
Like, who's drinking tonight?
Me.
Oh, I got a cherry whiskey I'm drinking on.
What about you, Heather?
I am drinking a vodka soda.
Oh, nice. And you, Nudie?
She means White Claw.
No, it's not a White Claw. No, it's not. It's not a White Claw. Why don't you shut the fuck up, Neil?
Oh, wow.
I know.
Been put in my place.
Oh, yeah.
I took an edible, but if I want, I got that more Courvoisier if I want to
add a Courvoisier, how fancy.
Pretty good shit.
Fancy schmancy.
But yeah, I just had like a nice edible about a half hour ago, so. Getting there.
Barney did this.
Now you can't come in here. There's broken glass everywhere, and you could cut yourself.
How's your allergies, Mona?
This is an old friend of mine I ain't seen in a long time.
A non-existent today.
Oh, why did he say beep? I was like, what the fuck's wrong? I forgot he did that.
They don't want you to know her name till like the very last fucking second of the movie. For some reason, her name is a secret.
Yeah, I forgot about that. How old are you,
Nikki?
Nikki?
Her name is Beatrice.
Yeah. Beatrix.
Beatrix?
Beatrix Kiddo.
He calls her Kiddo the whole movie. You think it's a nickname, but that's actually her name. She'd be about four now. Pretty good, Quentin.
Very smart.
He is good.
Which I'm actually honestly shocked we have not done another Quentin Tarantino film before this.
So many movies, not enough podcasts, man.
Right?
So many movies I want to do.
it's tough because I love Quentin Tarantino, don't get me wrong, but I've seen so many of his movies and it's like, to me, like they're kind of like fine wines, you know, like they're every now and then-ers. Can't watch them all the time. You want some coffee?
No, yeah. I haven't seen this movie probably since I got it on Blu-ray, so, you know, a long time ago. So
I haven't seen this.
Thought it would be a good one to do.
It's definitely been before I got married, so it's been over 17 years.
Jesus.
Fuck.
Dang.
Did you fucking get married when you were 15, bro?
I was with my ex-wife 4 years before that, so yeah, like that. But no, I was married 10 years. I got married when I was 28.
Oh, wow.
So I just got a message from a friend of a show on my Instagram because I posted my Cheech and Chong tank top, and it was from Sander Kane, also known as Sander Kane from Cemetery Podcast. And he said that, you know, I never get invited on the show. You should bring that up.
Oh.
So I'm going to leave Nudie to explain why Sander's not allowed on the show.
Oh,
I love it. I've known that dude since the beginning of time of podcasting, like since I started podcasting, I've known Xander. I've asked him 100,000 times to come on NFW. Always busy, always busy. But now because
not this show.
Now because you
NFW.
Guys are
this is
now
that
you guys are on this show, he wants to come on this show. Oh, I get it now.
Okay. And this is a cooler show.
I understand
like,
now.
It's true though. It's a cooler show.
Do you think? Do you think maybe it Nudie could be the fact,
even Steven,
that you have set the bar at a higher level, just high enough for Mr. Xander Kane?
I think that's exactly what it is.
To bless us with his illustrious presence.
Yeah, that must be it. It's not that he likes you two better than me.
He does love me. It's true.
Well, and him and I are good messaging buddies, too.
Yeah, like, actually, I think we're all really good friends with Sander, but you.
Just
kidding. Ow. Just kidding.
Oh, well.
Heather, you are feisty.
I know a secret about Sander that you guys might not know. However, do you know what it is?
He's got a 13.
He's really hot. Is that what it is?
No. He's afraid of koalas.
I'm going to ask him that right now.
It's true. I'm not kidding.
Says you are afraid of koalas.
That's why you can't come on the show.
And he says,
we got a koala as the guest.
That is why you are afraid to come on the show.
Or
wow. Amazing.
Now I gotta find koala pictures. Hold on.
It was on one of the
hold on 1 second.
All My Heroes Wear a Mask shows.
Listen.
Are you calling him? Oh. Your hair in
a black star.
Stop me from talking for that. Anyway. He used to be on a show called All My Heroes Wear Masks. And he said something that he's afraid of koalas on the show. Oh, wow. I don't even know what the reason for it was, but kind of funny.
I'm afraid of their cousins, the drop bears. Those things are scary.
So that's where that show was where I was learning my Photoshop. And at the time, I couldn't even like do great, good looking heads or just like square heads. Because I couldn't do around their heads. Shut up. And, so I used to post pictures of him holding koalas and shit.
Oh, she took a knife right to the fucking sternum. That was a good one. We should. I want to. There's one person that I want to podcast.
Tell us what you want. What you really, really want.
I want a podcast with Dan Chase.
I want a podcast.
I want a podcast with Dan Chase and Lacey Liu, but I don't think Lacey will have me. But
oh, well, yeah, I can ask her.
Is she like housewife horror?
Yeah, she likes,
probably already hates him.
She hates me because I called Scream housewife horror. The pumpkin.
So did you see my Scream post lately?
Yeah. And then I called it the pumpkin spice latte of horror films. I don't think she appreciated that.
Oh, she's very defensive over Scream movies.
Yeah.
So she's probably mad at me. And I'd like to fill practice podcast with Philip Perrone.
Oh God.
Oh no. Bully him. You bully him. Like he doesn't understand. Be nice to Phil.
I don't bully.
I keep telling him that he's hosting our show, but he still continues to harass him.
No, here's the thing with Phil. Like, I'm trying to get him to think outside the box.
Okay, he's not going to.
Yeah, not gonna happen.
Like, I get what you're trying to do, but he doesn't. He doesn't see it. He just wants to listen to Taylor Swift wear her outfits, and
he wants to wear her skin. I think
post selfies at the gym. That's what he wants to do.
Guys, come on.
I don't think
I would tell it to Phil's face. Phil, if you're listening, that's what you dig, and there's nothing wrong with that.
I just want to come out and say that I think you want to wear Taylor Swift skin.
Well, I don't think
yes.
That's an accurate opinion.
Wait, where did you get that truck?
All views and opinions of the Android virus are not the opinions of the. Is it? It's
not. I would love to podcast with Phil.
Phil listens. I don't think
too
so.
Many shows.
I'm surprised anybody listens.
I don't even know that they do. Do we ever get any feedback on this show?
We do. People do like this show.
We never get feedback. I don't think I've gotten one piece of feedback on this show.
Well, you know, sometimes... Oh, no, I've had people send me feedback about it.
Fuck those guys. I can't believe you're hanging out.
That's why you're just telling us now.
No, I told you before.
Oh.
No, I told him before, like a long time ago. I had someone that used to send me feedback about it frequently.
They said we're pieces of shit?
No, they said it was really funny.
4 or 6 months earlier in the Paso, Texas.
We're pieces of shit.
I mean, so, I don't mind being.
Well, it makes you feel better, Mona. You would have been a piece of shit because you weren't here then.
Yes.
I'm a whole shit.
This guy, what's his name?
Michael Parks.
I love Michael Parks. He's great. Is he the same? Isn't he? Okay, so Michael Parks reprises this character along with his son up there in Death Proof. They are the father-son cops in Death Proof, which is really cool.
I think he might have even played this same character in the Rob Zombie thing. Houses of a Thousand Corpses, one of those Devil's Rejects or something. Because I believe he was in one of those movies as a sheriff like this too.
I think probably so. Back in 06 or 07, a lot of those guys kind of... There's a weird little horror resurgence going on in the American horror community between, like, Eli Roth, Rob Zombie, Quentin Tarantino, Robert Rodriguez. A lot of those guys were kind of all in that time throwing down horror movies. And I feel like they somehow crossed streams. I don't know.
Yeah, I think so. Well, in Death Proof, I mean, the Grindhouse film there, they all did trailers and all that, so maybe Zombie was like, hey, can I use your sheriff character?
Yeah.
I mean, he might be totally wrong about that, but...
I mean, it's a possibility, though.
Yeah. I mean, look, I thought, you know, it was the same character now that you look at it. But,
yeah.
Well, sure. You know, look them up and see if they have the same character name or not. Just to satisfy my curiosity. You can tell by the cleanliness and the car. All right, let's see. Michael Parks.
Heather, I was talking to this girl I work with about how Canadian sensibility is everything that I want to be, but born opposite of.
Wait, what sensibility are you referring to?
Like, really nice and not ever looking for a fight.
Well, there's just some things that aren't worth fighting for.
I know,
I guess I know the wrong Canadians, because that wasn't my experience.
Yeah, you know Will. Yeah, I know.
No, I know. No, Will's nice to me.
Yeah, Will's a very nice person, but Will has very strong opinions on lots of different things.
No, that's not the only Canadian I know.
Oh, she had this this Canadian man that she was talking to that was my dad's age. How old is he, 75?
No, I don't know. I think he's 50-something now.
And they were lovers. They were online lovers.
Oh, that's sweet.
Oh, he was ashamed of me because I'm American.
Oh, no, that's a thing. Yeah, no, I get him. No, it's like, there's some really bad Americans. They make you guys look bad. I used to not like Americans either until I met Moore.
Till she met me is what
she's
saying.
Yeah, no, like, really. It's not a joke. Like, a lot of Americans they make it harder for us when we travel. The moment someone finds out you're Canadian, they treat you differently. It's a thing. So, sorry, Mona. I'm sorry that you met that. Because you're a nice American. He should have given you a chance.
He did. We known each other for a long time. There's other issues, too.
All right, did you bang?
No,
damn, Heather, just digging deep, are we?
Virtually. I don't know if he went deep or not. Like, we don't know that, Scott. He could have been pretty shallow. We don't know what he was packing.
Oh my god. Girl talk.
Oh yeah, he was right packing, in on this. But...
Well, also, you know I am one of the ladies.
Right?
Only on the weekends, right, Scott?
No, all the time.
All right, well, I researched it. He was not in the Rob Zombie joint, but like you said, he was in the Grindhouse double feature, playing the same character in both movies.
Yep. Michael Parks.
I need to watch that Grindhouse with the trailers again. Freaking love that.
Yeah, it's a good movie. That was the first movie I bootlegged. And let me tell you how I did it. I went into the movie theater with a little camcorder, sat at the top row, brought in my camcorder and threw my jacket over it. And I recorded the whole thing. It came out really, really good. Got the sound really, really
That's
good.
Impressive.
And then I uploaded it to Kazaa or something.
What was it back then?
And people were downloading it for me. I was a fucking pirate. I think the statute of limitations has ran out, right? It's been like fucking 15 years.
Yeah.
I feel like you do way worse things than that. So I think it should
be fine. Yeah, like post gaping assholes.
Hey, that's Goatsy, bro. That's Goatsy.
Okay, who
He's a legend. Goatsy's a legend.
Yeah, another one of your Albuquerque legends.
Goatse. He's the Goatsy. Oh, look, she's making her smell her pussy. Jesus Christ. I just put my finger in my pussy and smell it. It's going to wake you up.
Yeah, it is like smelling salt sometimes.
I know. I'd smell Daryl Hannah's pussy. I mean, come on. Who wouldn't?
I mean, it's Daryl Hannah.
I think you'd smell anyone's pussy.
This is not true, Mona. I'd see some of the homeless chicks in your area, bro.
Oh, my God.
And that ain't happening.
Mm-hmm.
A little too ripe for you?
No, ain't happening.
Not ripe. That's always a funny word.
A little too gamey, we'll say. Scott, gamey.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm scared. It's pretty scary. Hello,
Bill. What's her condition?
I have a Kill Bill replica sword.
Nice.
Very nice.
Real.
Dude, where is it?
It's in my daughter's room. It's next to her other samurai sword.
Shit. Will you keep your voice down?
You don't owe her shit.
Yeah, I
say. Daryl Hannah, man, when she gets pissed.
I remember the first time I seen Daryl Hannah was what? Attack of the 50-foot woman? But you
didn't kill her. First time I seen Daryl Hannah was on Splash.
That's what I was gonna say. Splash?
Yeah. And then later on in Blade Runner. But I mean Splash was made after Blade Runner, but
I've still never seen Blade Runner.
What the fuck is wrong with you, Scott?
I've seen it in, like, bits and pieces.
Are you serious? Nudie, how long is Blade Runner?
Probably like 2 hours.
Long.
Yeah, it's a long movie.
Fuck. Break my own rules here.
Yeah. Don't want to hear it.
So we're going to watch Blade Runner?
Blade Runner, the original, is really good.
I love both of them.
The remake is
It's not a remake, it's a sequel.
Oh, sorry, a sequel. It's kind of boring.
I've never seen none of them.
No. I like them. The original.
Wow. Never had a desire to see them.
Love them, love them, love them.
I do. Yep,
Blade Runner number one, just about 2 hours.
Yeah. Oh, that's not bad. But I guess that's not a win.
Oh, my God, the other one is 2 hours and 43 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck that.
Yeah.
I'm not interested in seeing it, let alone sit for 3 hours.
Speaking of which, I'm going to go watch Batman on Sunday, and that's like almost 3 hours from what I understand.
Yeah, I am so waiting for that to come to, like, VOD. I am not sitting in a theater for that long.
What's wrong with you, Scott? Just take your fucking colostomy bag and a fucking pisser fucking piss in the fucking popcorn bucket, bro.
Plus, I've seen enough Batman films. I'm not in a rush to see this one.
I know. I don't care at all about this movie. Not
really?
Does not look intriguing to me at all. Mm. It seems like every Batman movie is the same Batman movie every time.
This one,
you shut it.
They're skipping the origin story, by the way.
Good. I hope so. Jesus.
And it's starting off
what happened to him? Did his parents die?
How many times are we going to see the origin story?
Skipping the origin story.
Oh, so we're just going to get right to it.
Oh, that's how she woke up, huh?
This moment. This is me.
Masochistic.
Well, it's
aww.
Bill.
My I just found out my grandpa, my uncle, my grandpa and his brother and his other brother, which are three brothers, obviously my two uncles. Are going to have a a banner made for them and put up in Santa Fe, New Mexico, because they're three brothers in World War II.
Oh, wow. Nice.
One of them passed away. He died in World War II. But anyways, my grandpa and his brother. Yeah.
Nice.
Very hard good. Men. Aw, baby's gone. They yanked her.
They yeeted the baby.
They yanked it.
Yeah.
Now, oh, you got talking to talk Gen Z.
That was the cult that John D. Hart was going after.
Yeah.
The cult of babies.
Yeah, the baby crushers.
When are we going to interview that guy?
Let's do it. Next movie. Let's watch his next movie. Hey, Mona.
What?
I'm sending this in the chat. Look what I got. Oh, I already showed you.
Yes.
Can anybody read palms?
Can a baby read palms?
Said, can anybody read palms?
Can I read palms?
Because nope. She was just showing her palms.
No, I can't read palms.
Heather, okay, can you read palms?
Cards. I wish. Usually I just have white stuff on my palm. Sorry.
Wow. Okay, I want to say this guy to the right. He's a Carradine brother, by the way. I don't know if you guys know this.
The guy in blue?
Yeah.
I did not know this.
He is fucking in a lot of shit. He was the bad dude in Breaking Bad. One of the Nazi in Breaking Bad. The white supremacist.
There was a bunch of them.
He was one of them. He was the main guy.
Okay.
What the fuck is his name? He's in a lot of fucking movies. And by the
way, this little Jasper spitter, Jed, I don't know. But spitter, no
punching. Now we absolutely positive. What a fucker, man!
Yeah, this is disgusting. Rule number two:
no monkey bites, no hickeys. No monkey bites, no hickeys. No marks of no kind. After that, it's all good, buddy. Michael Bowen. Plumbing down there don't work no more, so feel free to come in. His siblings: Christopher Carradine, Robert Carradine, and Keith Carradine, and David Carradine.
He don't look like a Carradine.
He's got a different mom than the rest of them.
Makes sense.
Yeah, but he is a Carradine. Just a different
mom. Yeah, it's all dirty.
He's in Jackie Brown, Valley Girl, Kill Bill, Less Than Zero. Ton of movies.
I like Valley Girl. I like Less Than Zero.
Yep.
What has this rapist been in?
He's been in a lot of stuff. I can't
Isn't
remember.
He,
was he in Waterboy?
He was.
No, he
was. And then he was. Yeah, he was in Waterboy, and he was also in the Death Proof, the guy who they borrowed the car from.
Yep.
Okay. I thought I'd seen him. Oh. And his laugh is. He had the laugh I remembered.
And he used the line, "My name is Buck, and I'm here to fuck from what the hell is that movie called? Eaten Alive."
David Carradine was also in Night of the Comet, Iron Eagle, Last House on the Left, Forbidden
World.
He's just
not a guy I recognize. I've seen all those movies, though.
Yeah. I mean, he's just kind of one of those actors, man. All cheerleaders must die. Yo, stuck. Time's up, buddy. Valley Girl's really fun. Have you seen Valley Girl, Heather?
No. I have not.
Valley Girl's good.
I love Valley Girl.
We need to do some more romance comedies on this show.
Do we?
I spit on your grave.
Yay!
I'm down, but that's a horror movie. No, Mona's not comfortable with that. We're not doing that.
I know. I'm sorry, Mona. I forgot you weren't comfortable with rape.
Who is?
Why, Android? Why?
What?
You know why.
I know. He's like, look,
here we go into movies. The vortex.
No, look what she's doing to the rapist. Look at this.
I don't know who Bill is. Oh, shit.
Ugh. This Buck. He likes to fuck. Hey, he's got my wife's tattoo on her knuckles.
My name is Bucks, and I'm here to fuck.
So strange. That was my first dog's name.
Fuck. Your name. Do you fuck? Like his fuck? Your dog's
like
name was
did
fuck.
You like the buck fuck?
Right.
I love that twitching leg too, just like that. That's awesome.
A stomp on his penis.
Nobody will notice me.
Cat glasses on now.
There you go, Heather. I just took a picture of Rachel's knuckles.
Oh, okay.
Pussy wagon. Pussy wagon.
Fucker.
And they put it in the group.
Aw, Rachel. I love Rachel. She's so cool.
She's tattooed fuck on her knuckles.
Oh, well, she's cool. I mean, she's a badass chick. Your wifey is a badass chick.
She's got a nice ass. Ask Mona, right?
Yes.
Well, I think she actually is very beautiful.
Thank you. She's got them high
chairs. Still confused why she's with you.
She's got them high. Fuck you, Scott. Scott.
Everybody wonders that, Scott.
She got them.
Aww.
She got them high chairs.
Now we can't hear him.
Can't hear me?
No. Nope.
Very quiet.
Yeah. Your volume went from 60 to zero.
What about now?
A little better.
A little better. The last thing we actually heard from you was you, Scott.
I think how's Rachel that? And Android are a good-looking couple, actually.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Yeah, much better.
And no, I agree, Heather. I just got to give Android shit because
of course.
Because of what he did earlier.
Oh. You know,
with your girl?
Yeah.
Wait till I get the sex video between Scott and his girl and Photoshop my face on that one.
I'll make sure you're the first one to see it.
Yes. Make sure you send it.
That'll be you. Will be my number one priority.
Aw.
She's great. So, is there any rumor to the truth that Quentin Tarantino has a fascination with feet?
I mean, I think it's just because obviously he likes. Yeah, I think it's like every movie he's like obsessed with feet.
He said rumor to the truth.
Rumor to the truth to the rumor.
Yeah. Every well, movie he does, he has scenes like this. I think it's pretty clear.
Yeah, her feet are not.
And
really
he even wrote feet. That he would. He even those are pretty nasty. He even wrote that he sucked. What's her name's in the From Dusk Till Dawn?
Well, yeah,
Selma Hayek.
I mean, I'm not. I'm not a huge feet guy, but I'd put Selma Hayek's feet in my fucking mouth.
I know, but if that doesn't tell you that he is.
And then I heard that he was the stunt hand for Kurt Russell when he was tickling Rosario Dawson's feet. And
I wouldn't doubt that either. Wiggle your feet.
And it sounds like, from what I've been hearing, I guess he's got one more film that he's doing and then he's done.
Yeah, I listened to a really cool podcast with him.
I could see the faces of the cunts who did this to
on, Joe Rogan, and he's like, I'm ready to be a dad. Like, he's a dad, but his kid's really young, and he's just like, I'm fucking ready to experience that side of life.
Yeah, I guess he's living in Israel right now. Yeah.
I wish he would do a horror movie before he quits.
Yeah, like, yeah. That's the closest he's done.
I don't think he will, but he
wanted to do Friday the 13th.
He said, actually, he is still going to continue to work, but just not in cinema. So he's going to be doing producing movies. He's going to write novels and he's going to write plays.
Interesting.
Yeah, but he's not going to do any more movies. Oh, the origin Oren.
Oren Ishii was
beautiful
born
woman.
On an American military base in Tokyo,
yeah, I remember when she started off on what was called Channel 1 when I was in homeschool.
Who? Lucy Liu?
When you were in homeschool?
It was, or no, oh, sorry. Homeroom.
No, that was Lisa Lee.
That was Lisa Lee, you fucking asshole, Scott. That was Lisa Lee. Not Lou.
Wait,
what are you saying, Scott? What are you saying? Scott, all Asians look the same, you fucker?
No, I swear to God, she was in this.
That's very racist, Scott.
I'm just kidding, Scott. I love you. I don't think you think that.
Where did he go?
Wait, guys, you upset Scott.
Scott! No,
I'm looking it up right now.
Oh, okay. I was like, Scott, no!
Yeah, I thought he got mad or something.
I know, well, no, Scott, I'm sorry.
Oh my God, it's Lisa Ling. And that's no!
So how cool is this to put in Tarantino to put a little anime in his movie?
Great. It was shocking to see it, so it was cool.
Yeah.
Going through her IMDb now. Just
Lucy Liu is, regardless of wherever she came from, Lucy Liu is a very beautiful woman.
Oh, absolutely.
She came from her mom's vagina, just like all of us.
You know what, Nudie? How dare you? Not all of us came from our mom's vagina, okay?
Some people had C-sections.
Exactly, and some babies are born breech out of the mom's butthole. And that's another thing, Nudie.
Where I came out of a cabbage patch.
There's an episiotomy, and kid breaks through the wall between the vagina and the anus, and the kid comes out the butthole. You might have been a butthole baby, bro, and you don't even know.
No, now that explains a lot about you and your fascination with poop man and everything else.
Have you asked your mother, mom?
Maybe I understand it now.
Mom, was I a butthole baby? Go ask her.
No, it's okay. We are, you are now understood in my mind. I never understood you before, but now I get it.
I am not a butthole baby. I'll let you,
you
know
must be, because your fascination with everything around there and the poop man and puke man and zit man and, and snot man and pus man. So
what's
clearly
wrong?
Something happened.
What's wrong with the spicier side of life? That's my question.
Clearly something happened on the way out. So maybe you got squeezed out the wrong hole.
Not the butthole.
The ear hole.
I was squeezed out of the pussy hole.
Don't
and
die over.
Yep, man. Apparently I was wrong. Yep, she was not on that channel one.
No way, wrong. You were wrong?
No, Scott.
It's well, okay, Scott.
My life is a lie.
It was
I have
Lisa Ling.
This... Yeah, that's what I was saying. Well no, that's what I was saying. That's why I looked it up, because you were saying Lisa Ling and I'm going, wait, no, I thought it was Lucy Liu.
That's funny. My friend said the same thing last week. I was like,
really?
No.
Wow.
Wrong Asian.
Who, Victor?
Yes.
So I'm editing. So Mona, I'm editing the next Android Vision, right? And I start off the show with saying, calling somebody a cocksucker, and then because we're drinking more and more, right?
Yeah.
And then I'm apologizing to Victor. I'm saying, I'm sorry, Victor. There's nothing wrong with being a cocksucker. I'm just letting you know, man. I don't mean it that way, because Victor's gay, right? Mona's friend. And he was there while we were filming it. And I go on this fucking rant of, why do we have to attribute being a cocksucker as, like, a fucking insult? It's not an insult. People like sucking cock. What's wrong with that?
I like
getting their cock sucked, too.
Yeah. I like it. There is nothing. And I think we need to work in this society. And changing the fucking term cocksucker into being a fucking bad thing, because it's not. It should be a fucking term of endearment.
I'm going to practice that now.
You know what, Heather? You're a fucking cocksucker, and I love you.
You know what? I am proud to be a cocksucker.
There you go.
I do a really good job of it.
That's awesome. And I'm proud to have my cock sucked. Not, you know what I mean?
I know what you're saying, and I respect the game.
Yeah.
Heather's picking up what you're putting down.
Yeah.
I'm not going to tell Scott he's a good cocksucker.
And you know, Scott, I don't
care. You know what, Neil? If there was the best cocksucker, it would be you.
Never.
You know, Scott, I don't care how many cocks you suck, Scott.
40.
You're still my 40. Fucking brother from, you're still my brother from another mother.
Luckily for love you, buddy. Boss Matsumoto was a
pedophile. Ooh.
At 11.
11 years old, killing a fucking pedo. There you have it.
Matsumoto.
Fuck that guy.
He deserves worse.
Oh.
I love it.
All right, Nudie, are you gonna have me how are you gonna have me Photoshop Dan Chase because he's posing next to a guy dressed up as Robert Pattinson's Batman?
What?
Watch. I'm gonna send it to the chat. Everybody got really quiet all of a sudden.
I'm right, just watch trying to think of what you're talking about.
Here you go. I sent it to you in the
We're
chat.
We're in the middle of a show and you're worried about Photoshop and Dan Chase. What do you want?
Oh, Dan.
There you go. Look in the chat.
Yeah, I see it.
I see it.
Oh! Bye-bye knee.
Ow.
Eyeball. Eyeball, oh. Eyeball, eyeball.
Flat.
By 20, she was one of the top female assassins in the world.
Wow.
I'll be right back.
She worked her way to the top.
Heather, weren't you saying you're not huge into animation?
Yeah, I don't mind it, but I'm not the biggest fan.
Yeah, I'm with you. I don't know. I'd rather
it's
watch
okay.
a movie. I don't mind this because it's only like 10 minutes and
sure.
it's not the whole movie, but I'm not into cartoons, really.
Like, I watch stuff like South Park and Bob Burgers and stuff like that, but I can't do anime.
It depends on how violent it is,
At
I think.
At 25, she did her part in the killing of 9 innocent people, including
I don't know, I got a
daughter. In a small
involved in Bob's Burgers, I watched, you know, the first few seasons, and I just stopped watching. Even
did you
Family
Guy. Coming out with a movie?
Fuck
yeah, I'll probably watch that, but
live action?
No,
a cartoon movie.
Ah.
But however, live action would be cool. Satisfaction would be I want to see a live action Beavis and Butthead.
First things first. Yeah, did you hear they're coming back?
We can get Philip Perrone to play Butthead.
Oh, good lord!
My God, you're all over that.
I think we could.
We're gonna have to get on a new network.
I'm wondering if you have feelings for Phil.
I think he does.
Because you talk about Phil like he talks about Taylor.
No.
Yeah. There's this documentary on YouTube you should watch.
You belong
it
with
It shows
me.
The fanatics in love with Tiffany. You should check it out.
Yeah. It's called I Think We're Alone Now.
Yeah. So you should watch that. Just think of Tiffany as Phil.
No.
There doesn't seem to be anyone around. One way.
That's good reverse psychology there, Heather. I like it.
I'm so smart.
She's an educated white woman. What can I say?
She sure
true.
Is.
Fuck
above
my privilege
fucking...
in the house.
She drinks a lot of smart water.
Smart water.
Smart water.
She's above my league. What can I say?
Oh, that's not true. I am not above anyone's league here.
She's taller than you, that part, yes, but...
This is true. To find out that Scott fucking Crawford is fucking 5'7", and I'm 5'6", and Heather's taller than him and calls him short, that's going to fulfill my dreams to climbing up on a fucking Gigantus one of these days.
Gigantus.
You're tall in personality.
What's that?
You're tall in personality.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. You're way tall in personality. No, too fucking tall.
May I sit at the bar? I really want to fucking I'm trying to get Brian Stone King to podcast what with us as well, Judy.
Can you get his sister Brienne instead?
I was just gonna say,
yeah.
That guy's insane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll have to show you guys. I'll have to send you the video of when me and Sean used to do our podcast, and well, we used to do a live podcast. So it was, we had a call-in. It was basically a call-in radio, online radio show, and we used to have him just do weird little things for us, and we had him watch Two Girls and One Cup while eating chocolate cake.
Oh, good lord!
He probably asked for seconds.
No, he's all, oh no, I'm gonna find it. He threw it up on his YouTube. He has an old YouTube channel that was insane. He got obsessed with these dogs in his apartment complex. So Heather, Brian Stone King, he's, I think he's legit Asperger's, but he's kind of like on the kind of like I don't know.
Now you're making fun of me. We're all talking shit about everyone.
No, I love Brian. It's cool. But anyways, he got obsessed with a dog in his apartment complex, and he said the dog looked like Will Smith. He's all, there's the Will Smith dog. Ha ha ha. And he would like film the Will Smith dog every day. Then he found another dog that he said that looked like who's the Ron Perlman? The Ron Perlman dog. No, yeah, that was the other dog.
Why a cat who looked like Russell Crowe?
But oh, yeah, the Japanese tank. Oh, that's amazing. Okay. Was he fighting around the world? Oh my god. Russell Crowe fought around the world. It's a South Park reference.
So Sonny Chiba, R.I.P. Right?
Yep. A lot of people in this movie are dead now. Uma Thurman's career.
No.
I beg your pardon.
Drink. Drinky.
Oh yes, a bottle of warm sake, please.
Warm sake. Very good.
Very good sake.
Sake. Mapiru makara.
Who gives a damn?
Get the sake!
We should make shirts that say that. Get the sake.
Sake, good.
This is the shit that Tarantino's famous for.
Right?
Dumbass scenes that don't really go anywhere, but they're fucking amazing.
He's a master at dialogue.
I like how Quentin Tarantino, he earned his chops working in a fucking video store in the 80s. Just watching shitty films.
Yeah.
Definitely a movie guy for sure. Everything he'd done.
Hopefully one of these days, one of us will make it, right?
I think we're beyond that point.
Oh, no. Yeah. Jesus Christ.
When you make remake Road to Revenge.
This is true. We can do it.
We should remake Porky's and have Scott run down the street as Pee-wee.
Fuck yeah. No, I'll be Beulah Ballbreaker.
Yeah. I'll be meat. See, none of you idiots went for that, so I had to.
I'll be meat.
Too late. We took it.
Oh,
Hatoro Hanzo
sword.
There's an old video I filmed of my daughter cutting watermelons in half with that fucking sword.
Huge.
Huge.
It's gonna be the bigliest.
I think we lost Boom Boom.
Who's Boom Boom?
Boom Boom Powell.
Oh.
Nobody can ever accuse of Quentin Tarantino of presenting strong women in his films.
No.
But again, maybe he just does it so he can fucking tickle their feet. I don't know.
I'm sure. I'll make sure they walk around in at least a scene or two. But I think based on her feet, he clearly hired her for her acting skills.
What's the first movie everybody saw Uma Thurman in?
Johnny Be Good.
Me too.
You too?
Yep, that's it. That's the first movie I saw her in.
I think that because she was like just a kid in that movie. Remember Anthony Michael Hall as a football player?
Yeah.
I think for me,
were in that movie too.
I think for me, it may have been Pulp Fiction.
Mm. What about you, Heather?
I don't think she's here.
I know. I think she went and she left. Somebody pissed her off.
Heather can't come to the phone right now.
Where did she go?
I know.
Maybe she went to go get another drink?
Maybe she had the shit.
Why did she take us with her?
Because nobody wants that.
Says you.
No, that's right. Android likes poop. I forgot. He's into that. You don't deny it, you notice? He just laughs.
He does not deny it.
Probably got a secret room full of scat porn.
No, I don't. There's nothing sexual about it to me. It's just more. It's more comical. You know what I mean? I think it's just that's the thing about farts and poop and stuff. It's a comical thing. You know, it's not sexual.
And I'm hard.
He worked for that one. He tried to work hard for that one.
He didn't try very hard.
I like this one.
I no longer make instruments of death.
All right, we are now into the pod listen portion of our show.
The what listen?
The pod listen, because we're all listening and not talking.
Story development.
Hey, it's a great movie, and you know,
that's the downside of picking good movies, is we get distracted.
We're all here to have a good time watching a movie.
You missed Road to Revenge, where we all got really distracted, not because it was good.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that was the best. If you guys haven't heard that show yet, is it really that bad episode, Road to Revenge, by the legendary John D. Hart. So, yeah, go listen to that shit. And listen to after the show as well, when Android actually calls the fucker and he answers the phone.
Tell Scott the story. Scott just said, what?
Yeah, we watched this shitty movie, Scott, that I saw a review on YouTube of, and we were supposed to do another show, but it got canceled, so I said, shit, let's just jump on and do one. So I had the movie ready to go, and it's called Road to Revenge. Written by, starring by, directed by, songs by this guy named John D. Hart. Never done anything else. And let's just say it was pretty fucking epic. Oh, and Wings Hauser was in it.
What the hell?
And William Smith. So two really good actors, you know, from the day. And this guy's like $2 movie, which I don't understand. And he also hired a Playboy Playmate to play his girlfriend in the movie. So he got sex scenes with a Playboy Playmate.
Of course.
So it was pretty, let's say, would you say it rates in the same area as maybe Samurai Cop, Android?
Yeah, Samurai Cop. What else did we watch on this show?
Winter Beast.
Miami Connection.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like...
So it's in that vein, Scott, as being like really bad. And so while we do the movie, Android looks him up, and the guy's a lawyer in L.A. now.
Oh, no shit.
So he actually called the number of the guy, and the guy picked up, and it was like one of the funniest calls you'll ever hear. he just He was definitely the guy we watched in the movie just by listening to him talk and his responses to everything. Fucking amazing.
Like, that Android, is incredible.
It was funny when he starts talking to him, he put on his little Chicano voice. Hey, man, how are you? Oh, geez. I was like, wow, he went to Chicano mode. And the guy's like, he goes, call him, looking for my friend John. And he goes, well, this is John, but I don't know no Mike Merriman.
Oh, my God.
He said his name was Mike Merriman.
Wow.
So he goes, so Android said, like, okay, I guess, you know, I got the wrong number. And he goes, oh, you reached your best favorite actor. It was like so great. Like, he just played along into it. He must get calls from like a lot of people that watch that movie and look him up, you know, because he amazing. Right away he went to you've reached your favorite actor. And he's and Andrew's like, oh, you were in a movie. So they talked like for 5 minutes about the movie. And oh, it was amazing.
It was so weird.
Wow, I'm going to listen back to that. Holy shit.
It's like I added it into the podcast as if it were like...
It's at the end of the show.
Oh, that's amazing.
It's amazing. So we might actually call him and try to interview him.
That is awesome. Holy shit.
Then the movie was a limited edition on Vinegar Syndrome, or one of those. And
of course it was.
It's all sold out and... It's what I show you, like $499 for one of them that somebody was trying to sell.
Jesus.
Yeah.
But the guy cut the movie 3 times. So it was Road to Revenge, and there was like another one called Champagne and Bullets was the original name.
Oh, was, yeah, remember that.
He spouted off the movies, too. I was like, what movies you been in?
Yeah.
Champagne and Bullets. Road to Revenge, and then after I hung up, you just get Willis and Mona and Nudie just laughing their asses off. Oh, like
it was funny as hell.
Willis, yeah, it was hilarious. So that's the replica. Amazing. That's the replica sword that she's holding that I have.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
So yeah, the guy does sings in the movie, and he wrote a song, the Shimmy Shimmy Slide or something like that, and it's fucking hilarious. The whole movie's like Mystery Science Theater 3000 level. It's amazing.
Okay, I'm definitely gonna be downloading that tonight. It was 1 year after
the massacre in El Paso. You can watch it on YouTube for free.
I was so glad that I found the.
Well, no, I'm talking about the episode. In her
Shakespearean. Oh yeah, it's on Spotify.
I found that YouTube show. It was incredible because, like, wow, this movie would be perfect for that show. And the final
sword with she. Jesus
Christ,
Android, what are you doing?
He's farting again. A crazy 88. Why are you playing that?
You said you
seriously.
Like, you said you
what
liked
are you doing? You're like 3 hours too late. Like, you play it now, and we talked about that 20 minutes ago. Like, come on, man. You're no fucking Fred from the Howard Stern Show.
You said you liked poop.
Good Lord. The young girl in the schoolgirl uniform. I think that Chinese girl there is in a band, and she was like a musician or something. Young, but what she lacks in age, she makes. Oh, I might not be right. I don't know. Where did Heather go?
You just made it up.
I'm here. I've been here the entire time.
We haven't heard a word. We've been talking about how you haven't said anything.
I don't want to. It's fine.
Don't tell her what to do. She's her own.
She took a nap.
Don't tell her what to do, Nudie.
That's right.
If she doesn't want to speak, she doesn't have to. I'm not.
Oh, yeah, we were talking to you and you didn't answer us.
Oh, I probably put it on you.
Yeah. She was fucking, you know what? If she had 2 fingers in her asshole or 2 fingers in her pussy, I don't care what she was doing.
I appreciate that you gave me the variety there.
Yes.
I have my option.
Or in your mouth. I don't care. Whatever you were doing.
In someone else's mouth.
Exactly. From your asshole to their mouth. ATM, baby. I don't care. Yes. See what I mean?
All right. The bald guy in the She wasn't in a band, but she was a model back in when she was a young kid. I guess she was a model.
Oh, nice. And just in case you're wondering,
How could a half-breed Japanese-Chinese-American become the boss of all bosses in Tokyo?
She was in Battle Royale in
2000. Oh, okay.
It might have been her first thing.
Speaking of Battle Royale, do you know what I did?
Good movie.
Do you know what I did, guys?
No, what did
you
do?
Battle Royale?
I fucking watched The Hunger Games Part 1 and 2. And
what did you think? Tanaka thinks
is... It was pretty good. I didn't mind it. I thought it was all right.
I've only seen the first one.
I mean,
God, this scene is so good here.
They're not bad. I mean, it's like a dystopian kind of future thing. I can appreciate it. I can respect it. It's a little brutal, but I can see where it's not a very original idea, but it wasn't bad. I liked it.
I've never seen it. Mona, did you see it?
Yes. The first one is all right. It's for children.
What was that, Heather?
This scene is so sick. I love when she fucking loses her mind on the guy. That's like what I fantasize doing.
What? I love how she dances across the table.
Yeah.
He's pissed about fucking a woman being in charge. He don't like it. They're all making money. What the fuck? Who cares?
Right. Yeah, let Tanaka talk.
Perversion. Oh, she's a half-breed. That's why he don't like her. Ooh.
I love that.
Wow. Part. It's hilarious.
So good.
That last spurt.
Whatever she is, she's beautiful.
Right?
As your leader, I encourage you from time to time, and always in a respectful manner, to question my logic.
It's a very corporate speech, which I like.
Tell me so.
Corporate speeches,
and I promise
you right here. You haven't had enough of them? No
subject. Oh my God. I fucking hate corporate America. Don't even fucking get me started.
Like work.
Ugh. You know what sucks is I work for corporate America and I gotta suck corporate America's dick to maintain my lifestyle. It's really tough. I'm sorry. It's really tough.
Who you're talking to? You know where I work.
I know, dude.
Anything else to say? Now's the fucking time.
There you go.
I encourage you to watch. There's a film that Xander and I reviewed. I think it was like one of our last Kill Reviews podcast shows. God damn, it was about a Disneyland movie. Dude, you ever heard of it? It's a black and white film.
No.
Escape. Ah, fuck. I would encourage you to watch it. I'm trying to find the name.
She gets on the plane with her sword.
Yeah, no one blinks an eye.
She thinks she has it all.
Made in 2013, it's called Escape from Tomorrow, Nudie.
Okay. Gonna tell me how to escape? Is there a way to escape?
It's a 2013 American independent surreal life psychological horror film written and directed by Randy Moore. directorial debut. He tells the story of an unemployed father having increasingly bizarre experiences and disturbing visions on the last day of a family vacation at the Walt Disney World Resort.
Okay.
It was later a personal selection by Roger Ebert, shown at the 15th annual film, blah, 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 blah. They were working on some legal issues. And I don't know if it could be screened there because obviously it was on everything at Disneyland. It didn't show anything. Like, as far as he's, you know, he's like filming himself in front of something, you know?
Yeah.
It's a trip. Fucking weird.
Scott went to get a drink.
Oh, me too. I'll be right back.
I'll be right back.
ERB.
No, to never say I'll be right back in a horror movie.
Well, luckily, it's not horror.
Okay.
Waka
waka.
Waka waka. Are we watching part two now? Next time?
Part two? When?
Yeah, Kill Bill part two.
Next time?
Yeah.
You should.
Like, I guess that's what we have to choose next time, isn't it?
Yeah. I guess we'll have to have a second episode of our 50th, so 50.5. No, thank you, Heather. We will do that next time. Android will probably be so happy.
I'm here for the good ideas.
But yeah, you can tell him when he comes back.
I'll let him know. Well, I remember how long was the wait between these two. Do you guys remember? Was it like a year?
Yeah, it was only a year or two, yeah.
Something like that, right?
Yeah, it wasn't much.
No, they didn't keep the gap too long.
Last year, 2003, 2004.
Fuck, wow. Almost 20 years ago.
Now, jeez. Part two is a long movie, Heather, so we might have to start earlier or do it on a different
day. How long
day.
Is part two?
2 hours and 17 minutes.
Oh, fuck that shit. Never mind, we're not doing part two.
We can maybe pick another day where we can start earlier.
Yeah, but we can't because of the time zones.
Can't what?
The time zones.
Who's in a different... Well, we could make it work, maybe.
Well, no, Android doesn't get home till a certain time.
Yeah, I mean, we can do a different day or something.
Yeah, I guess.
I don't know.
You can do it when I come visit you. Do you want to podcast with these guys while I'm down visiting you in Florida?
You want to cut it off until September? Just doing part two?
I don't want a podcast, but I'm visiting you either.
Hey, Scott.
That looks like Asian Charlie Brown with his outfit.
That's what they call him, don't they?
Do they? Oh, I don't know.
Hey, Scott.
Scott's not back yet.
Hey, Jude.
Hey, Jude.
Not a fan of the Beatles, but I'm a fan of the individual guys who made up the Beatles. Put after.
Okay. The one person in the world that does not like the Beatles. Android
like
virus.
What?
Bono don't like the Beatles.
How can you not like the Beatles?
Because they fucking suck. That's
why would I like the Beatles?
Why
like
wouldn't you?
Like,
a boy band at that
Beatles
time.
Are catchy.
Yeah, they're a lot of cool songs.
They're just fun, fluffy songs.
But I do like the music they put out after as individual artists. So I'm saying I dislike them. I don't like the music they put together. Maybe one later Beatles when they're damaged and done with each other.
But yeah, I'm more or less like, they're okay.
By the way, Scott, really quick, I'm gonna let you know I had a package show up on my doorstep today.
Oh yeah?
I'm like, what the fuck is this? And I opened it up and I'm like, I ordered this for Scott for Christmas, and they told me it was out of stock, so that's why I got you the other thing, right?
Right.
Let's see, what is it?
So your present came in to me.
I'll be damned.
Did they charge you, or did they?
Of course they charged
it for
me.
Nothing.
Of course they charged me. It was out of stock, and then I fucking got it. I order a lot from Big Bad Toy Store. Just different action figures. This came in, and I'm like, oh, I thought it was one of the action figures. Or Scott's present. That'll be shipping it out to you, hopefully by Saturday or something.
Oh, well, you don't have to do that, dude, but thank you.
No, I have no use for this, sir.
Okay.
You will have more use for this than I do.
Is it that a is sex hilarious. Toy?
It can be a sex toy. It can be used as a sex toy.
Man, I hope it's a gizmo dildo that I can shove up my ass.
That's what I was going to say. Is it a gremlin dildo? Gremlin vibrator?
Like, when you get it wet, it turns green and gets all veiny.
Scott, you could use it during sex, though.
Oh, sweet.
Use anything.
I'm all about using anything during sex.
What was that, Mona?
Then you can use anything during sex.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, how can you use your eyelid during sex?
Well, it's there.
You give butterfly kisses, man.
Yeah. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Or flip
a butterfly kisses. Oh,
it's way to use your eyelid.
All right, so how do you use toe jam during sex?
You snort it. It's like an aphrodisiac.
Heather, where'd you find this guy?
I don't know.
Michigan. Heather, you can ask me the same thing about me.
Yeah, that's true.
How much do you think these bitches sold this to the Geico fucking company for?
Oh, a ton.
Yeah. Scott, shall I take a picture of your present, or do you want to fucking be surprised?
Oh, I don't mind either way. If you want to take a picture, send it in the group chat, go for it. If not, then I'll slow down for surprise.
Okay, I'm going to take a picture because I'm a little...
This whole song, all it is, woohoo, woohoo, hoo.
You need to pinch them.
Right?
Right? Here's the thing, you're like...
That was a cool little effect.
Hi, what actually this got? Hi. Hi. Renaksaki wo oshiete itadakereba kochira kara renaku shimasu.
I love this music. You gotta play like a phone ringtone or something. Alright, yeah, Charlie Brown.
Charlie Brown.
Oh, no shit.
Oh, that's cool.
That is amazing, Android.
It's big. As you can see.
That is awesome.
And the pupils move around too, like googly eyes, you know.
Nice. Oh my god, that's amazing.
and the white hair is real.
I am so wearing that during sex.
It's fucking scary.
It's kind of disturbing, but I love it.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Wow.
She knows who she is.
Yep.
She took her baby. Better watch out you fuck over. They're gonna be out for revenge. That's why I don't fuck anybody over.
That was a mark.
No. That's a good one.
Oh man.
Has anybody here seen Tokyo Gore Police?
No.
No. Is it like this?
Yes. Takes all the really gross stuff from anime movies, like people modifying their bodies but in weird ways. So like you have like women who genetically alter their legs to be like... like there's a chick in the bottom half. There's a chick in the bottom half of her body is like a Tyrannosaurus Rex. So when she opens up her mouth, like it's her pussy. It's weird. But anyways, Tokyo Gore Police. It's stuff like this. It's just blood spraying everywhere.
Is that a trauma movie?
No, it's not. Tokyo Shock made it.
I think I have it on Plex.
Oh no!
This guy's gonna die quick.
Cut her sword right in half, huh? Cut his sword in half.
That's where Texas Chainsaw stole it from.
Yeah, right. I love this scene.
Yeah. She ain't fucking around, is she?
Fuck no, she isn't.
I love it.
Want you, bitch.
She's like, next.
Come on, fucking bring it.
So didn't Quentin have to black and white this to pass the censors?
Yeah.
Oh, he did.
The homage to Bruce Lee. So whose pick is it next?
I believe it's either yours or Mona's.
Heather.
Wait, is it Heather? I thought she already picked.
No, she went silent again.
Oh.
She said, "I am watching."
She wanted to do part two.
No, and that kind of how long it was.
I'm not done talking to him yet. The problem is, it's 2 hours and 17 minutes.
Oh.
So I was saying we could maybe do it on a different night where you can start earlier.
Yeah, maybe in December or something.
December. Yeah, legit.
Other than that, I don't know who's the next.
I think it was after you, Nudie, to be honest with you. I think it was you, me, Heather, Scott, and then Mona.
I'm glad I got to pick episode 50, but
so who's next?
So whoever's next, I don't know.
Because Mona did
River's Edge.
Here, I'll give you the order because I still have all the art saved in my phone.
Was that our last episode?
No, our last episode was Death Race, which was mine.
All right, so it was Mona, Scott, me. So it's either Heather or Android is next.
Heather picked
Fangs.
Oh yeah, she did Fangs. That was she after did Fangs.
So then it's you.
All right.
Next time after her, you it'll be Heather, and then Mona. Yeah. And down the line.
Mona.
Hey, don't mock my speech.
Like Tony Danza.
Mona.
Aww, like who's the boss?
Angela. Samantha.
I love it, Mona. That's awesome. God bless you. You got allergies up there too, huh?
No.
You okay? You got COVID? You good?
No, I don't think I have the cough.
We call it the bat stew flu out here.
Oh, nice.
Why are you laughing, Mona? That is not funny. I made Mona laugh.
Yeah, she really liked that one.
It's crazy how long this 17-year-old kid goes against her.
Right?
She's a badass.
Oh, yeah, she's 17.
Oh! I like how he spliced in the fucking,
bowling sound.
Bowling sound.
Strike. It's a phantasm blade.
I can do that.
Sound effect. Now I'm gonna pay for this drink of this beer.
Oh
later.
Man. Forgot about the scene.
Oh. Oh.
Bam.
Beautiful life cut short. Killed her best assassin.
That'll learn her.
Great.
Wow.
Her Nike's dead.
Such a great scene, though.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely. Sick.
Great scene.
I really forgot how good this movie was.
So did I.
I will now be watching part two within the next few days, since we're not going to do it. Because I love it.
We are going to do it for a Christmas special.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Sure. So, yeah, an idea what you want to pick yet? Or
you and me? I put a list of movies that I want to pick, and I'm looking at the times, run times, before I make a call. But I kind of think I might know, but I'm not sure yet. Think it is?
You didn't think it was going to be that easy, did you? You know, for a second there? Yeah, I kind of did.
Oh.
Tricks are for kids.
And I think I want to go with the theme on this next one, where I want to appease everybody. So I want to appease Mona, and I want to appease Nudie, and I want to appease Heather, and I want to appease Scott.
That'd be everybody.
That's a lot of pearls.
Yes.
A lot of peas.
So when I really break it down in my mind, Scott's easy. He's the easy one. He's down for whatever. Yep. Heather... She's not down for anime or...
Oh, I can watch anime.
Sci-fi fantasy.
Anything that's under an hour and a half, I like.
Well, there we go. So that helps me. But she's not... she's not down for sword and sorcery.
It's fine. If you put sword and sorcery on,
she's only saying that because it's you, Android. If it's me, she's giving me shit.
Stop it, Heather. You don't have to appease me because I'm appeasing you.
Mona, that's a lot of peas.
A lot of peas. We got a lot of peas going around here. Mona. Mona's the ride or die. Mona's the ride or die. So she's good to go for whatever. Nudie. I don't really give a shit about Nudie. I love you, bro. Nudie. I'm gonna start calling
forgets,
Nudie. And
Nudie. Forgets who keeps his wife happy to the TV viewing.
Yes. Ooh, she poked an eye out. So this is where it got real bloody, huh? The sentries came in and said, nope.
Yep.
Water.
I'm sure there must be a colorized version out there, right?
I don't know, man. I think there is.
So amazing, though.
Straight fucking Jason.
Yeah, the choreography here is incredible.
So good.
Yeah, dude, I think we're gonna do this 45.
All right.
I'm just kidding. I wouldn't do that.
I've been waiting to watch it for the 15th time with you.
I wouldn't do that with you or Mona. Oh!
Ah, the real scream. She can fly, she can fly.
Zoe Bell, amazing stuff.
We should do Deadly Prey.
Oh.
We should do this 45.
We should do Mad.
Heather, I love you very much. The bottom of my heart. But I will not do this 45 on the account that I love Mona.
Oh, that's right. We can't do this 45. My bad, Mona.
No.
Because Mona sucks and she's not in shape.
No.
You
know what? No one needs to be great, alright? Sexual assault is never something to be like.
Sexual assaults are not fun.
I tried. I watched that movie Revenge and it was a mistake.
Revenge? I've never seen that.
It's a French film.
Going with a blonde?
Yep.
In the desert?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
that
good.
Movie was decent. Yeah.
I got a bit ridiculous at the end with some of the stuff.
On Friday Nightmares, you guys did one of my favorite trench films, Frontiers.
Yeah, oh, man. That's awesome. A gory one.
That's a good one, isn't it?
I don't think I've ever seen it.
Yeah.
Me neither.
That was the first
time.
Me neither. Me neither.
I didn't see it either.
That's, What did we do? That's me neither. What did, Willis? He was calling his daughter. By the way, that show that Judy stopped the show.
Yeah.
Fucking Willis takes a call from his daughter.
Streets of Desire.
Streets of Fire, where Willis takes a call from his daughter, and we just put it on the podcast.
Yeah. He thought he was on mute.
Oh God.
I encourage everybody to listen to Is It Really That Bad? It's a fucking funny show, man.
Our shows are fucked up.
I mean, our shows are fucked up on here, but theirs are fucked up in a different way. They're fucking weird. They're hilarious.
It's a different dynamic.
Yeah, it's fucking funny, man. Fucking Willis.
It's nice he timed the black and white color switch to her blink.
Yes.
This guy knows what he's doing.
Gino's a
fucking
genius.
You know, it's funny. I don't think I've ever been invited on that show. Oh, that's interesting. Scott's been on it. Mona's been on it. Huh.
Mona's part of it.
Wow. Wow, Neil. Wow.
Hey,
Mona.
Wow. You're the one who told me you were too busy to come on my NFW anymore.
Heather.
And I said, whenever you want to be on a show, you let me know. And you don't let me know.
Heather, I cordially invite
you. And now you know.
Wow.
Yeah, she's like Xander. She don't like me. Did Xander ever respond to you? The koalas.
I don't think I can meet him.
Can't hear you.
But yes, he may join us at some point.
What did he say about the koalas?
Fucking been podcasting with this guy for almost 10
years.
He
said whatever to me and rolled his eyes.
Yes.
Oh,
we'll say he did something similar.
Do you see this? How she's like cutting, like cutting his penis down to nothing. She's making him impotent.
He's a little kid. This is what you get for fucking around with Yakuzas!
Your mother! This is what you get for fucking around with Yakuzas!
That was his son.
Yeah, it's... I mean, again, I was busting Nudie's balls, but I haven't seen this movie in a really long time, so it's great fucking film.
It is. Like, I can't talk because I'm so into the movie.
Right?
Yeah, it wasn't the edible movie.
Yeah, that's it.
Wasn't the edibles. I'm about to send fucking Nudie some edibles, Heather. Scott.
Do it.
Mona.
Do it.
Send me some.
That's a lot of bodies.
You don't fucking know where I live. Just put your fucking hand in the fucking treasure box in my fucking garage, Mona.
You just not gonna take them?
Take it.
Just come to the Android Vision set, Mona. You know where it's at.
Yeah, while you're there, do some makeup.
Yeah.
I know.
It was very nice
of
you to thank me at the end of the show.
I'm gonna bring the not melty one next time.
You know what?
But I'm not touching your eyes.
By the way, because, bro, you've hooked me up with a lot of fucking movies. You've helped me out with a lot of things as far as that show is concerned. I've asked you to fucking send me movies before that I can't find on YouTube or whatever. So, of course, I'm going to thank you. You're my brother from another mother, man.
Yeah, that's the first time I saw it at the end, you know? So it was cool. Other than that, one time you and the ghost called me out.
I don't even remember that. Sorry.
I have a video clip of it.
We called you out.
Fuck you, Neil LeMoy. And she's like, yeah, fuck you.
Me and the ghost.
I think it was a Miss 45 joke. I think you said, we're not going to watch Miss 45. And you're like, fuck you, Neil LeMoy. It was funny. And then when you
ghost.
Did the taxi theme, was it?
You
had me in there. The credits for that too.
That was a good one.
Your instrument is quite impressive.
That's when Sean used to edit for me. He used to do weird shit like that, taxi themes. And
I'll send you the video if I find it. Okinawa.
Fuck! Okay, so the movie I want to pick is an hour and 45 minutes. I'm not going to do that to Heather.
Thank you.
I love you, Heather.
If we start at 8 o'clock, we'll be done by 10.
Some of us get up and go to the gym in the morning, and I like to get my beauty sleep. Look, Neil, not all of us are as good looking as you.
Yeah, okay? It's just 2 hours. It's not
yeah,
like
I like to get my sleep.
Just 2 hours.
I like it a lot. And not all of us, like, Neil, I get that you're beautiful the way you are and handsome all the time. Some of us have to work at it.
I am. You
like,
got
when
that
I'm
right.
a 2 and you're a 10, like, what do you.
Oh my God. Stop, stop already. You're gonna make me come.
Okay, fine. I'm a 4.
4K, baby.
Yeah, right. Oh, you're too kind. Too kind.
God damn. Sorry. All the movies I'm picking are like over an hour and a half.
Well, if they're an hour and 40 minutes, that's fine. I just don't want
to. Blah, blah, blah,
blah. An hour and 45 is too much.
Like, it was a dog day night. Fucking depressing. It was great.
Oh, but... dog day afternoon?
Yeah, whatever it was. That was long, wasn't it?
Yeah, a couple hours.
Yeah.
Attica.
Yeah, it really sucked because I really wanted to Blood In, Blood Out. It's such a great movie.
Neil, when I come to see you, we can watch it, okay? Together.
Okay.
In person.
All right. Wonderful.
And we won't have to do a commentary throughout it. We can just watch it.
So,
have you ever seen the movie?
No, I'll come watch it with you. I'm serious. It's just doing the commentary I find it awesome.
It's fucking awesome. It's like 3.5 hours long, but it goes by so fast.
When I come visit in September, we'll watch
So I feel like this is really where like Tarantino came into his own, where he just used a lot of really cool fucking backgrounds. It's falling snow, the contrasts, all kinds of crazy shit in this movie, which is really good. And this part, he's using fucking like kind of mariachi type of music, right, Mona?
Yeah, kind of. Sounds like disco cowboy music.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's hey, like a sped up version of a soul song.
Hey, Mona, did your parents ever used to party at the caravan back in the day?
I don't know. I don't think so. No, they went to the Action One. South Valley.
South Valley.
Are you going to pick Short Circuit?
I am not sure. I fucking
hate that. Danny Five is alive.
Oh my God. Even as a child.
Can't hear you.
Can't.
Far away.
You must speak up.
Oh.
Even as a child, I hated that movie.
That's because the movie's boring.
Great. That's going to be my next pick then.
If my mom would have let me walk out of fucking Short Circuit as a fucking kid, I would have.
I saw that one time and I've never watched it again.
There's a reason. You may not be able to like a
samurai. Even part two? At least die like a
samurai. Yeah, part two was even worse.
Fuck!
I think I saw the first one at a drive-in.
Every movie I want to pick is like fucking 2 hours. Okay, I'm going to get it. We leave.
She said an hour 45 is okay. So what was your first pick?
Looking, hold on.
I mean, there's no reason we can't just log in and start like right away. I mean, we talk hijinks throughout the show anyway, so
okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4 of you, okay?
Yes, there are. Thank you.
And I have 4 movies I want to pick, and I'm gonna be a fucking.
Are we gonna vote?
We're gonna vote. Heather,
no,
you down?
Just pick your movie.
Scott, you down?
Yeah, sure.
No.
I'm down.
Listen, dude, don't tell me how to run the fucking show. Look, I'm going to fucking do this. I'm really buzzed.
I'll tell you and you'll like it.
I'm really buzzed tonight. I'm sorry, guys. So,
that's okay.
So, I have Blue Steel with Jamie Lee Curtis.
I was just on the other day.
What? Was it?
Yeah.
I have Romancing the Stone with Michael Douglas and Kathleen Turner.
So far, Blue Steel's my pick.
The Last Boy Scout with Bruce Willis. And a sleazy little fucking Tokyo Shock film called Ricky O, The Story of Ricky.
Oh, Ricky O. Fucking love that movie.
Ricky O is good. But I feel like we've done that a couple times already.
Blue Steel.
Yeah, I would pick Blue Steel.
Heather?
Yeah, Blue Steel's fine.
All right. She goes with the colors.
Jamie Lee Curtis, Heather.
Taking a nap.
Yeah, sure.
Heather goes with the colors. I love it.
I went with the crowd.
Then we should do colors.
And Scott. Color purple. Scott. Ikuyo.
Yo.
Blue Steel?
Yeah, I'm fine with Blue Steel. I'm fine. I'm fine with whatever. But yeah, Riccio, fucking great movie.
Yeah, the first time I watched Riccio was on Android Vision, and they didn't have the whole fucking movie. I was fucking mad. I was so pissed.
I'm sorry.
I'm like, dude, there's like a minute left, and it just seems like there's a lot more movie to come. Sure enough, it just ended. I was like, son of a bitch. It was so good. It was like the first time I ever watched it, and I was like, wow, this movie's great.
Oh, yeah, the movie's insane.
I had to search for it to finish it.
It really was a Hatanzo Hosari sword. Hattori Hanzo.
You are buzzed.
Sorry.
I like that her head's talking without a body.
Well, just the top of her head is missing.
Her brain's exposed.
I thought she chopped her head off because I saw the body fall.
She chops the top of her head off.
Yeah, you've seen her scalp fall.
Yeah, we've seen Ray Liotta talk with the top of his scalp off.
I fucking hate Hannibal. It's so stupid.
So, Blue Steel?
Let's do it.
Blue
Steel's good. Blue Steel. I don't think there's any rape in that movie, is there, Heather?
I haven't seen Blue Steel. I don't know.
You know what?
Well, is that the one with Ron, what's his name, stalking Jamie Lee Curtis?
Ron Silver, Jamie Lee Curtis.
Yeah, it might be somewhat of a scene. I'm not sure.
Here, let me check.
I'm going to have to download it because I don't have it. I'll have to see if I can find it.
It's a fucking good movie.
Yeah, it is good.
I've never seen Ricky O.
Ricky O is like...
The two girls haven't seen Ricky O, so I don't know. Heather, we're going to... If rape is a thing in Blue Steel, which Heather's going to research for us...
Yeah, I'm reading
right
now.
She's a good researcher.
You're really good.
What? Look at her. She just dumps her fucking like a sack of potatoes off the side of the road. No arms and legs.
Nugget.
Just listen to fucking Metallica 1 on her fucking iPod.
She's gonna freeze out in the snow.
How's she gonna ever masturbate again? Oh, she
How's she gonna live without bleeding to death?
She shouldn't even be alive right now.
I know. She should have been dead already with all that blood squirting out of her.
I suspect there is an uncomfortable scene in Blue Steel.
There's an uncomfortable scene in Blue Steel.
I'm not sure if it's a sexual assault or just assault.
It's
but
a sexual
assault of a man on a woman.
It's a sexual assault.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't remember if he rapes her or not.
There is a sexual assault in it from what I remember.
We are not doing Blue Steel.
Let's do Ricky O. You cool with that, Nudie?
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. I think I have Ricky O. Let me see. I think I have a good copy of it, too.
Can't stop watching Yellow Jackets.
Really?
Yeah, yes. Ricky O. All right.
The story of Licky.
I've kept you alive for two reasons.
Licky O.
Brûlons l'enfer, espèce de salope,
blonde.
Je ne te dirai rien.
Blonde.
I love her fucking...
And every time can't hear you give me answers,
I'm gonna cut something off. You're far away.
And I promise you, they will be things you will miss.
You will miss.
I want. Can you hear me now?
All the information on the deadly
vipers. If you had to guess.
what they've been doing.
Why she left you alive.
And where I can find them.
What would be your guess?
Guessing. I think I'm going to master reset my computer. Is that what they call it?
Yeah, we format it.
Yeah, I'm gonna have Rachel do that for me while I'm at work.
Something might just have to be repaired.
I'm gonna have to reformat it while she's watching Young and the Restless. So you can
tell him. Everything bless you.
God bless you.
God damn you.
Are the junipers blooming up there, Heather?
No, nothing's blooming. It's snow and sadness.
It's still winter here. I want
you. The bloomin' onion? You got some bloomin' onions going on up
there? Oh, not yet, but there will be when the fairs happen.
Oh, yeah.
There will be when I go to Outback Steakhouse. Yeah.
Yeah, high five, high five. Well, I thought you're going to go see AEW, by the way, everybody.
Fuck, yes, we are.
What the fuck?
Yeah, we're going to Detroit.
Yep, June 29th. Nice. AEW Rampage, or Dynamite and Rampage in one night.
I'm fucking so happy for you guys.
Yeah, first time they've come to Detroit. That'd be fun.
It'll be my first time back in America in 2 years.
America! For
2 years. Yeah.
And it's the first time AEW has made it to Detroit, so I'm fucking excited as shit.
More important.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Yeah.
Last night was amazing.
Yeah, and Heather's coming too. No.
Yeah.
Heather's coming, all right.
Last night's show was amazing.
I missed last night. I seen the clips of the MJF CM Punk fight.
Yeah, he was bleeding like a pig.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
going to do a wrestling podcast next Thursday, I believe, so
nice.
If anybody wants to jump on, it's going to be me.
Yeah, well, the pay-per-view is on Sunday, so.
Are you uploading it at later? Wait, sorry.
As soon as I can get it, I will, but sometimes it takes a few days.
Okay.
Like the UFC, where I get that from, sometimes it takes 17 hours to download the damn file. It's so fucked up.
How I'm fucking annoying.
Yeah, really.
Oh, so that's the list. That is the list.
The shit list.
The shit list.
So she only got a couple to set when.
Man. Yeah, but it was worth it. It was a nice little fucking.
Is Bill.
Adventure. Thing, oh, poor Sophie.
Is she aware her daughter is still alive?
Oh no! Written and directed by Quentin Tarantino. Great film.
Fuck yeah.
Yep. All right, let's go down the line. You start with ours.
Okay, so where do I start? Quentin Tarantino holds a whole special place in my heart. Excuse me. Buzzed.
one beer.
No, dude, by the way, have you know that this is...
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Go on with your rating.
Why did you? Why?
Three fucking pints I'm sorry. In, motherfucker.
I apologize, everybody.
I don't drink a lot anymore. So you told rating. Me I have to drink on our fucking 50th episode, you son of a bitch.
Rating.
Son of a bitch.
Rating. Quentin Tarantino. Hadn't seen this movie in a really long time. I know I was busting your balls over watching this movie because I've seen it a million times, but I haven't seen it in a while. Great fucking film. Hold it in high regards. It deserves all the accolades it gets because it really is a beautiful fucking film and a beautiful fucking story. Love it. I would say 8 out of 10.
All right.
There you go.
Mona,
because I'm boring. See, I love the gore, the brutality, all the different villains or two. I like the anime parts. And even though I don't watch too much anime anymore, I don't like it as much as I did as a teen. But the movie was like a whole live action anime, so not just the Oren parts. But what are we rating? 1 to 5? 1 to 10?
1 to 10.
What is it? I'm going to give it probably a 9. This is like one of my son's favorite movies. So, yeah.
Scrot.
Next. Scrot.
All right. Yeah, like I said on the show, it's been probably about 17 years since I've seen this. Maybe a little longer. I can't honestly remember, but fuck. Revisiting it now... Yeah, this movie is goddamn amazing. It's just a perfect homage to like the old school, like fucking samurai films, revenge films. Great character actors, great cast, great acting, amazing anime style gore, very cool filming, like very cool shots, very cool cinematography, very stylized. This is definitely one of my favorites of Quentin Tarantino's, so this would be a 9.5 for me.
All right, Heather.
I don't know what there is to not like about this movie. There's so much female empowerment in it. I can't get over the scene where Lucy Liu chops off that motherfucker's head and the speech she gives. Like, and for 2003, this really was, you know, a really empowering film. I think Uma Thurman's great in it. I think the fight scenes are great. I think the gore is great. This is a 10 out of 10. Like, I personally haven't seen this movie in a long time, but yet there are certain scenes that I never forgot from, like, 17 years ago, kind of similarly to Scott. So, yeah, I enjoyed it.
All right. Yeah, what everybody said, I mean, can't add more to it. It's just a great film. I really loved watching it tonight. And I'm glad I picked it because it's been years. And I'm going to give it a 10. I love it.
Nice.
Booyah.
All right. So, yeah.
Booyah. You know where that came from?
No.
It came from, there was a porno, The Originations of Booyah. And this guy, he was fucking this chick in her pussy. And then he put his balls in her asshole. And then he popped his balls out and it made like a sound. And he went, Booyah! And that's where it originated from.
Are you sure?
That's a very interesting story. I feel like I've learned a lot.
Just letting you know.
I don't believe you.
And knowing is half the battle.
He was the one-man DP, as they called him.
Oh, good Lord. All right. Thanks for joining us on our special 50th episode of It's Not Horror. Until we meet again with Riccio. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Oh my god.
What?
You know what?
Oh no!
Really?
Potos?
No, oh, I didn't tell you guys the story about
me. No, I don't want to.
There is no story.
No.
Yeah, let me tell you. So, listen.
Oh, it's so late here.
No, so I'll edit this out of the show, I promise you. So, me and Mona were talking with Victor, and we know more stories than games. Just letting you guys.
Just don't know. Sigh.
I enjoyed.
I love you guys.
I love you so much. I really do. I can't
guys.
Wait to see you in 2023.
Can't wait to see you in Florida.
Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot we're gonna go to Florida together. I'll let you know when I book my tickets.
Okay, I'm down.
Can you imagine?
Oh god.
Poor Neil.
I'm gonna move.
I'm taking my fucking wife. I'm gonna take my wife and my kids.
Yeah, I'm gonna go visit Mona while you two are down here.
I'm gonna fucking I'm going to Neil's mom's house with my wife and my kids. We're gonna have a fucking meal. We're gonna hang out.
The house ain't big enough for you and all those kids.
I'm only having two with me, all right? The rest are out of the house.
All right. It's time to go, right? Because you all have to.
Yeah, I gotta get dinner.
You didn't want to do a 2-hour movie, but now you don't want to stop talking.
I gotta piss.
Good night.
Yeah, I gotta pee as well. Pee. Bye.
Bye.
Good night, guys.
Everybody's gotta go pee now.
Bye.
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 It's not horror, okay?
You've been listening to the Intestinal Fortitude Podcast Network. Follow us on Twitter, @I_Fortitude, or on Instagram, @TheIntestinalFortitude.